Welcome to Jar Your Mind. My name is Joey.
We're going to begin with this short reading and then end it with just a few minutes of a discussion on the I Am and who is I Am to you.
Thomas Troward's The Hidden Power, Chapter 3, The I Am. We often do not sufficiently recognize the truth of Walt Whitman's pithy saying, I am not all contained between my hat and my boots, and forget the twofold nature of the I Am, that it is at once both the manifested and the unmanifested, the universal and the individual. By losing sight of this truth, we surround ourselves with limitations. We see only part of the self, and then we are surprised that the part fails to do the work of the whole. Factors crop up on which we had not reckoned, and we wonder where they came from, and do not understand that they necessarily arise from that great unity in which we are all included. It is the grand intelligence and livingness of universal spirit continually pressing forward to manifestation of itself in a glorious humanity. This must be effected by each individual's recognition of his power to cooperate with the supreme principle through an intelligent conception of its purpose and of the natural laws by which that purpose is accomplished. A recognition which can proceed only from the realization that he himself is none other than the same universal principle in particular manifestation. When he sees this, he sees that Walt Whitman's saying is true, and that his source of intelligence, power, and purpose is in that universal self, which is his as well as another's, just because it is universal, and which is therefore as completely and entirely identified with himself as, though there were no other expression of it in the world. The understanding which alone gives value to knowledge is the understanding that when we employ the formula, I am, therefore I can, therefore I will, the I am with which the series starts is a being who, so to speak, has his head in the heaven and his feet upon the earth, a perfect unity, and with a range of ideas far transcending the little ideas which are limited by the requirements of a day or an hour. On the other hand, the requirements of the day and the hour are real while they last, and since the manifested life can be lived only in the moment that now is, whether it be day to day or 10,000 years hence, our need is to harmonize the life of expression with the life of purpose. And by realizing in ourselves the source of the highest purposes, to realize also the life of the fullest expression. This is the meaning of prayer. Prayer is not a foolish seeking to change the mind of supreme wisdom, but it is an intelligent seeking to embody that wisdom in our thoughts so as more and more perfectly to express it in expressing ourselves. Thus, as we gradually grow into the habit of finding this inspiring presence within ourselves and of realizing its forward movement as the ultimate determining factor in all true healthful mental action, it will become second nature to us to have all our plans, down to the apparently most trivial, so floating upon the undercurrent of this universal intelligence that a great harmony will come into our lives, every discordant manifestation will disappear, and we shall find ourselves more and more controlling all things into the forms that we desire. Why? Because we have attained to commanding the spirit and making it obey us? Certainly not, for if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. But because we are companions of the spirit, and by a continuous and growing intimacy have changed not the mind of the spirit, but our own, and have learned to think from a higher standpoint, where we see that the old world saying, know thyself, includes the knowledge of all that we mean when we speak of God. I am is one. This may seem a very elementary proposition, but it is one of which we are too apt to lose sight. What does it mean? It means everything, but we are most concerned with what it means in regards to ourselves, and to each of us personally it means this. It means that there are not two spirits, one which is myself and one which is another. It means that there is not some great unknown power external to myself which may be actuated by perfectly different motives to my own. and which will, therefore, oppose me with its irresistible force and pass over me, leaving me crushed and broken like the devotee over whom the car of Jaggernaut has rolled. It means that there is only one mind, one motive, one power, not two opposing each other, and that my conscious mind in all its movements is only the one mind expressing itself as, not merely through, my own particular individuality. There are not two I ams, but one I am. Whatever, therefore, I can conceive the great universal life principle to be, that I am, let us try fully to realize what this means. Can you conceive the great originating and sustaining life principle of the whole universe as poor, weak, sordid, miserable, jealous, angry, anxious, uncertain, or in any other way limited? We know that this is impossible. Then because the I am is one, it is equally untrue of ourselves. Learn first to distinguish the true self that you are from the mental and physical processes which it throws forth as the instruments of its expression, and then learn that this self controls these instruments and not vice versa. As we advance in this knowledge, we know ourselves to be unlimited, and that in the miniature world whose center we ourselves are the very same overflowing of joyous livingness that the great life spirit is in the great all. The I am is one.
Jesus himself in John says in 8:23, he said to them, "You are from below. I am from above. You are of this world. I am not of this world." Jesus has risen in consciousness. As we are growing to be, and that we can rise in our own consciousness to be one with the Father. But as of now, he was speaking to the masses to say, "You are from below. You have not awakened yet." When we are born into this earth, we forget who we are. We forget that we are God. And as we awaken, we become one with the Father. And this is the story of Jesus. All of us are saved by being one with the Father. Who do you say I am? That is your belief. I am healthy. I am powerful. I am energy. I am unaffected by my circumstances. I am the light of the world. I am beautiful. What is your current I am statements that you say to yourself every day, that you say to other people? And that is your truth. It is also just a state of mind that you can change and you can say, and go from believing in something outside of yourself to a knowing of the God that is within you and say, "I am energy and I am light and I am at peace and I am growing in consciousness." And that is the I am, that we are all one. And that we are all awakening, and this is an awesome time to be alive because there is a great awakening. And to understand the I am is everything. I just wanted to share that short passage of Troward's, and I hope it rang true for some of you. And please leave a comment and let me know what you thought. And I thank you so much for being here, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.